Kitchen Showdown. Don't miss that at 11:20.
Before that, it's the big showbiz story that's got everyone talking. Adele made her return to our screens this weekend. Our man in LA, Sam Rubin, is here with his reaction. Good to see
Morning,
you, Sam. Lovely to see
Morning.
You. So, big showbiz story. What's it all about?
Well, what it's about, really, Philip and Holly, good to see both of you. Good morning to the UK. Really good news here from the US. Adele returning to Saturday Night Live. It's as if she'd been in the witness protection program. Beautiful before and beautiful on Saturday night in a variety of ways. Let's start off with her taking the SNL stage.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome to Saturday Night Live. It's me, and my God, I'm absolutely thrilled to finally be hosting this show. A show, not only do I genuinely love this show, but the show that broke my career here in America 12 very long years ago.
Oh, that's exciting, isn't it? Just to hear her talking. We haven't heard that for such a long time.
It wasn't much of
a surprise, though, was it? No.
Well, no, she had made an announcement earlier in the week. And, you know, Saturday Night Live is getting an enormous amount of attention, but it's kind of had a rough go this fall. The episodes have been criticized for not being particularly funny. Here's the Instagram post from Adele saying, guess what? I'm going to host the show. So she made that announcement. My first hosting gig ever. If there was ever a time to jump headfirst in the deep end with our eyes closed and hope for the best, it's this year, right? And indeed, she was right. So, and Holly, that hair alone, look how beautiful
she
was.
Just glossy and gorgeous, wasn't she? Beautiful.
They teased the whole thing all week long. Let's show you the promo. This is her and Kate McKinnon and the musical artist, her.
Night Live this week with musical guest
so there
her.
They are.
Right, so tune in. It's Fit to Be Wicked. I'm sorry, bad idea. That was a bad idea. Yeah. Oh, my God. No worries, girlfriend. Okay, now that is good.
it's not her first time on the show, is it?
Certainly not. She's got a considerable history, Philip, with SNL. And as she talked about in 2008, her appearing on the show really did break her career wide open. She, of course, guested on the same episode that Sarah Palin famously appeared on during that election year. So the impact on the charts was extraordinary and really an overnight sensation because she had some music climbing. She appeared on the show and boom, she went right into the Billboard top 10. It really did make her a star here.
And we did think that we might get news of a new album launch, but that wasn't to be the case.
That was not to be the case. And Adele talking about that as well. This album has been delayed, 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 delayed. She referenced it here.
I know there's been a lot of chatter about me just being the host. I've seen all of it. Like, why isn't she the musical guest and stuff like that? And there's a couple of reasons. My album's not finished. And I'm also too scared to do both. I'd rather just put on some wigs, and this is all mine, by the way. Have a glass of wine or six and just see what happens. Who knows?
She did talk about her weight loss as well for the first time, didn't she?
Well, you know, here's the thing. It's kind of delicate because it's, you know, this extraordinary transformation. And is she okay talking about it? Is she okay joking about it? And the fact of the matter is, yes and yes. Look.
I know I look really, really different since you last saw me, but actually, because of all the COVID restrictions and the travel bans, I had to travel light and only bring half of me, and this is the half that I chose.
That's a great way to do it.
That
That's
is
a really
way to
good
do it,
way
isn't
to
it?
Do it,
just
isn't it?
Make a joke of it. And we didn't get to hear about any new material in an album, but we did get to hear her sing a little bit.
Oh, I tell you what, Holly, this to me was the highlight, and I cannot tell you the social media reaction, because I harbored this fear, as many did. All right, she's on the show, but we've got to hear her sing. So they put together what I would describe as sort of an excuse to let her sing, a bachelor send-up. And, you know, that's our show here, of course, all around the world, where a lot of women vying for the attention of one man. She plays a wannabe bachelorette who bursts into song. You'll know these songs, but most importantly, you'll know the voice. Did the dramatic change in her appearance change her voice? That, I think, was the fear. Finally, a big relief. Look.
I heard that you're settled down. Hello from inside this booth.
Hi, can I steal him for a sec?
There's a fire starting in my heart. Sometimes it lives in love, but sometimes it hurts and stays. Thank you, everyone. Catch me next week on Love Island.
She's so good, isn't she?
Really, really good.
And it's good. Nice because obviously you, those are like her big hits, and if you just said, oh, could you sing a medley? She probably would have been like, no chance, I'm not doing that. But it's great. That was like the perfect thing for them to do.
This was like a warm hug. I cannot tell you the reception. And I mean, I literally felt this viscerally. She opened her mouth and she sang as beautifully as she has always sung. And, you know, that power. And we've missed that voice. Mm. That was the big theme on Twitter, how much we've missed hearing from her and how absolutely great she sounded. Wow.
Thank you, Sam. Good. Thank you.
Thank you. Lovely to see you. Take care.
Likewise.
Bye-bye. Write more stories and making headlines next. Nick Ferrari and Nicola Thorpe are here with This Morning's View. That's right after this break.